you know, I've made some arguments about the results that this type of thinking can, or the questions that it can raise about African population and global context. I mean, I think we are on the verge of being able to compare populations of the different regions of the world over the last several centuries, and there'll be some big lessons in that. This sort of work has linked up studies of slavery in Africa, in the Americas, and in the rest of the old world, and showing interesting commonalities and differences. It also, I guess I'm just recapping what I said before, emphasizes common patterns in migration, and so one part of the website that I showed you uses the same methodology to analyze European transatlantic migration of the 19th century and African transatlantic migration of the 18th century. And now, of course, we know that the number of people who migrated out of East and South Asia in the 19th century and 19th and early 20th century was more than the number of people who left Europe. So the 19th century is not a time for European migration, it's a time of migration from the populous areas of the world to settlement frontiers. There are these gender differences that I mentioned give you situations in Africa with lots of extra females and situations amongst black in the Americas where lots of extra males. Those deform the family, marriage, child-rearing situations in each of those cases and suggests that by looking at these migrations and interactions, you can think about a world history of the family brought by migration. All right, and I don't have anything profound at all to say about this, except that I have been struck by the difference between digital history as about presentation, as a way of conveying the information, as opposed to digital history as a way of analyzing the material. I mean, in one sense, it's what we called a quantitative history when I started to work on this. It's analyzing numbers. And I think we learned more from the last presentation by Peter on this, by the interplay of the actual representations and your research questions, it gives you better ideas for representation of your answers and better questions. So it's this focus on digital history emphasizes interactive and multivariate analysis in a productive fashion. And I've tried to make the argument that you can address large-scale questions as well as small-scale questions with this. And yet the simple key is, just as I did with stumbling through the population figures for Africa, you just follow the numbers, and that'll lead you to the next issue. And that is, on the other hand, no different from what historians have always done, which is follow the documents. So there we are. Thank you very much.